All right, hello everybody, and thank you for joining me. In this video today, I want to tell you exactly what not to do when you first bring a new plant home. Now, to help me illustrate this point, I have my beautiful Ficus Lyrata Bambino here with me, and, what's that? You don't think it's beautiful? You think it's too sparse and there's not enough leaves? Well, see, what had happened was, now let me show you this picture of the way this plant looked when I first brought it home. Wow. Seriously, when I look at that picture, I only have two words that come to mind. God night. Okay, so I brought this plant home and I treated it more or less the same as the way I usually treat new plants that I get, but there were some other factors at play that caused this plant to react very, very negatively. And since it's a ficus, when a ficus becomes stressed, it tends to shed some or all of its leaves. Now, in the case of this particular tree, it lost about 90 to 95% of its leaves, which was devastating. It was hard to watch, especially because it was so lush and incredible when I first brought it home. Whew. So I want to save you that same heartbreak and tell you exactly what I did and why it all added up to affect this plant in such a negative way. Okay, so first of all, for me, it's pretty standard to bring a new plant home and repot it immediately. Now, I've learned over the years that this is not the best thing to do in many situations. So if you get a plant like overseas, international, or a plant that's gone through the mail for any length of time, really you don't want to mess with it at all. Just let it rest and acclimate to the home. But I do tend to repot things. If I buy it in person, I'm almost guaranteed to repot it right away, mostly because I like growing things in my own soil mixes that I mix myself that I've gotten very comfortable with over the years. Now, when I brought this plant home, I actually was not planning to repot it because that was interesting to me. I had never grown a plant in nursery soil, so I wanted to just leave it alone, but I started to see some little critters crawling around down there in the soil, so I decided to repot immediately. Now, the other thing that had happened was when I repotted it, I had a pot picked out. I wanted it to be able to stay in that pot for like 2 years, so I decided to prune the roots just slightly, maybe pruning them back about 10%. So that added a lot more stress to this plant, and I think that was really one of the main things that caused it to go wrong. So definitely root pruning a new plant that you just got, it's not a good call. You want to let it get used to your home. You should be getting really nice healthy growth in your new location before you ever start doing anything like that. So that was mistake number two, was root pruning. Now the only other factor, so I repotted, I root pruned, both of those stressed this out. The other factor was the amount of travel this plant had gone through and the change in light and humidity levels coming from a greenhouse to my home here. So when I purchased this plant, it had actually just arrived at the nursery in California and they said that it had come the day before from Florida. And because this is a large plant, the largest plant I've ever purchased, I'm assuming it's like 3 to 4 years old, so it spent quite a long time in a nice, perfect greenhouse in Florida. Then it got shipped all the way across the country to California. Then I brought it home and I repotted it and root pruned it and stuck it indoors. And all of that combined just was quite a disaster for this plant, and it has been a long time to get back to even this. It was really just like one leaf at the top of each of these stems for a long time. As you can see now, these trunks are way, way too long, so springtime, once this thing's growing nice and fast and we've made it through winter, I'm gonna cut it back, you know, all the way to about here or so, and that way it's gonna grow lots of new branches and it'll get back to its lush, beautiful, glorious self. And so I'll definitely make a video for that. It's gonna be really fun. I'm very excited for that actually. But I do wanna make sure that people are aware that Bringing a plant into your home is already stressful. That plant has probably been grown in perfect greenhouse conditions, and it's gonna have quite a shock just to go into a normal home interior. And so if you add a repot on top of that, which honestly I usually do, and also one of the main reasons I do that is because I've gotten fungus gnats from new plants. You can't always see them. You're not gonna find them in the nursery necessarily. So sometimes you bring a plant home and a week later you see some gnats flying around. And so just as a precautionary measure, I do like to repot, but that's an additional stress. And so if you're gonna be root pruning at that time as well, that's just gonna be way, way, way too much. So my best advice to you is to bring a new plant home, leave it alone for a couple weeks or a month. Ideally, you have some sort of quarantine zone set up. I recently put a grow light in our spare bathroom hanging in the shower. So when I bring a new plant home, I can actually just leave it in there for a couple weeks and there's no chance that it's gonna infest any of my other plants with anything. So I can keep a close eye on that. So that's highly recommended that you have some area like that. But really just bring it home, mix up your neem and soap oil, spray that plant, make sure that it's nice and clean before you put it into your collection. Yeah, all right, well, I guess that's it. I really thought that was gonna be a longer video, but yeah, it's really simple. Just keep in mind that it's very stressful for these plants to transition into the home. So if you're gonna repot, be gentle. Definitely don't do any root pruning and give your plants as much light as possible because they have just come from a greenhouse and they are used to having the maximum amount of light. So I hope that's helpful. I hope it saves you the headache or the heartbreak that I went through. But the good thing about plants is as long as your plant doesn't die, then it's gonna grow and it's gonna recover. And maybe it's gonna take a long time to get back to where it was, but eventually it's gonna be growing, it's gonna be beautiful, and you can start taking cuttings again, and it will be this amazing, amazing plant over time. All right, so I think that's gonna do it. Thank you so much for joining me. If this video helped you or you found it informative or entertaining, please drop me a like, and I would love to hear from you in the comments section. Although please don't share too many horror stories. Let's keep it on the positive note. But if you have any questions or concerns about your plants, please feel free to reach out. I would love to connect with you. Thank you all again for watching. I hope to see you in the next video. All right, peace.